In DNA-based information technologies today, we will discuss about bacterial artificial chromosome. In bacterial artificial chromosome, we will see what are bacterial artificial chromosomes, why they are important in cloning, and how we can use them as cloning vector. Actually, bacterial artificial chromosome is a DNA construct based on the function fertility of the plasmid, and they are also used in transforming and cloning in E. coli cells. Bacterial artificial chromosomes are specially designed for cloning of very large DNA fragments ranging in size from 100,000 to 300,000 base pair of DNA, and they also contain selectable marker genes. These selectable marker genes provide resistance to the antibiotics such as chloramphenicol, and they also have origin of replication. Origin of replication is the point where replication initiated. BAC also contain F plasmid, and F plasmid have a very major role because they have partition genes and they promote the even distribution of plasmid of the bacterial cell division, and they are also usually used in analysis of genome. So first we will see what are the main features of BAC vector construct. Actually, BAC vector contain cloning site. Cloning site are the point where restriction enzymes comes and cleave. It contains multiple cloning sites like EcoR1, HIN3, EcoR5, and BAMH1. And cloning sites also contain LAG-Z gene. LAG-Z gene allow for the detection of our insert, and they also contain origin of replication. Origin of replication allow for replication in bacteria, and they also contain chloramphenicol resistant gene. Chloramphenicol resistant gene actually allow for selection of transformed cell. BAC vector also have PAR gene. PAR genes are involved in even distribution of plasmid when bacteria are growing in number in culture. So, let's see how we can use bacterial artificial chromosome as cloning vector. So, first we cut our BAC vector, here cloning site, by the help of restriction endonuclease enzyme. Restriction endonuclease enzyme cut it and they produce sticky ends. Next, after this, we ligate our foreign DNA in sticky ends by the help of DNA ligase enzyme. Next, they form recombinant BAC vector. When recombinant BAC vector form, then we transfer this recombinant BAC vector into bacterial cells by the process of electroporation. What happened in electroporation? Actually, in electroporation, we supply electric field. Electric field create pores in bacterial cell membrane. Then DNA taken up by the bacterial cells. And when we remove electric field pulse, then bacterial cell membrane pores becomes closed. And here you can see our BAC recombinant have been introduced into bacterial cells, but we are not sure whether the bacterial cells have taken up the BAC vector or not. So how we can confirm this? So we confirm this by performing screening. In screening, what we do? Actually, in screening, recombinant DNA screen for resistance to antibiotics, chloramphenicol. We grow our bacterial culture in agar plate containing chloramphenicol and substrate for beta-galactosidase. Here we use X-gal as a substrate for beta-galactosidase. So beta-galactosidase convert X-gal into glucose and galactose, and they will produce blue color. Here blue color colonies indicate that DNA have not been transformed into bacterial cells, while white colonies indicate that bacterial cells have been transformed with recombinant BAC vector. So we will do blue white screening. In blue white screening, what we do actually, blue white screening is very rapid and efficient technique for the identification of recombinant bacteria, and it depends on the activity of beta galactosidase enzyme. And they are present in E. coli cells, and they cleave lactose into glucose and galactose. So we cut our desired gene of interest with restriction enzyme and cut cloning vector with the same restriction enzyme. Then we mix our insert with vector and DNA ligase. Then we transform E. coli with the vector. Next, we place them onto media that contain ampicillin, IPTG, and X-gal. Ampicillin are actually used because E. coli cells which are not transformed, they will not grow there because they are sensitive Ampicillin will kill E. coli cells while IPTG bind to the lac repressor and they induce expression from lac promoter. And XGAL is used as a substrate and it is cleaved by beta galactosidase enzyme and they form blue color precipitate. Here you can see XGAL. XGAL is actually analog of lactose. So XGAL cleaved by beta galactosidase into 5-bromo-4-chloro and 3-hydroxyindole and then it oxidizes to form 5-5-dibromo-4-4-dichloro indigo and it produces an intense blue color and it is insoluble while XGAL is colorless. So we can also use blue white screening to ensure the presence of active beta galactosidase enzyme and it will also allow for bacterial beta galactosidase to be used as a reporter in various applications. So as you can see here, it is our vector containing beta galactosidase coding gene and tetracycline resistant gene. We will insert our foreign DNA in lac Z gene. After transformation into bacterial cell, there will be three cases. First possibility may be foreign DNA not inserted into the vector, and when we grow them on agar plate, they will produce blue colors because plasmid is without insert and they are tetracycline resistant and lac Z gene is functional. While in case two, plasmid no transforming into bacterial cells after growing bacterial cells on agar plate, bacterial colonies will die because of tetracycline because they are not tetracycline resistant and they have no lac Z gene, no plasmid present. While in case 3, foreign DNA inserted in bacterial cells after growing them on agar plate, white colonies form. Here plasmid is with insert and tetracycline resistant and non-functional lac Z gene. White transformant actually indicate that they have our insert and blue transformant indicate that plasmid don't have our insert. So through blue white screening we can confirm the presence of recombinant back vector. So it's all about today's lecture. See you in next time.